Alien Covenant introduced the Neomorphs. Their life cycle was different than the standard xenomorph we all know. When the black goo pathogen was released by David on Paradise, it would make its way across the land and infect some type of plant or fungus. The pathogen was known to only infect life forms, so it's possible this plant had some type of organic matter to it. Now you might ask yourself, how is that possible? And the simple answer is, this was on a planet inhabited by the engineer race, so it could be one of the many things we don't have on Earth. Now the Neomorph's life cycle would start out from these plants infected by the black goo pathogen. When the plants are disturbed, they open up and release motes that travel through the air. It would enter a living host through their nose, ear, or mouth. Then it would go into their bloodstream and create a blood burster. As the blood burster grew inside them, the host would become sick, weak, and unable to walk, thus making it easier for the blood burster to erupt from the host. The Neomorph would come out, and even in its infant stages, it would be aggressive and dangerous. So, if you compare this to the Xenomorph's life cycle of an egg, then a host that has to be impregnated by the facehugger, then the chestburster would come out, but the chestburster is not as dangerous in its infant stages. They tend to run away and hide so they can grow. Now the question here is, how is the Xenomorph's evolution superior to the Neomorph's, when it seems the Neomorph's life cycle is better in many ways? Well, when David created the Xenomorph, he realized he could not be there all the time to keep making alien eggs. Then, at the ending of the movie, he mentions he has one last thing to perfect, his queen. This is referring to the queen alien, and this fills in the missing gap of how the Xenomorph evolution is superior to the Neomorph. Aside from already having a hard exoskeleton body and acid for blood, the Xenomorph's life cycle is now complete. In order to create more Neomorphs, you would need a constant supply of the black goo pathogen, something David does not have. But when you have a queen alien, all she has to do is create eggs. Although both alien types still require a host, this just means that David does not have to be there to assist them. Even though the Neomorph life cycle process seems to be more effective at creating that type of alien, the simple fact of not having any more black goo pathogen is what makes this species obsolete. No black goo, no Neomorph. So that's why the Xenomorph evolution is superior. But which alien species did you like more in the movie? Let me know in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave a like on it and subscribe with notifications turned on. I also have a Patreon page if you want to support the channel that way. Thanks for watching. My name is Acid Glow, and I'll see you in the next video.